Thank you, Chairman, and thank you for invitation to this lovely place. I will give a short history about the laser history in dermatology in Egypt, only in dermatology. Well, the ancient Egyptians were pioneers in introducing the benefits of light in medicine. And this plant, the Amimagus lineus, was used by the pharaohs as photosensitizer in conjunction with the sun exposure to treat some skin problems. In the new era, in the middle of the last century, Professor El Mofti from Cairo University in Egypt reintroduced the use of sorolens with light therapy, PUVA technique, to manage vitiligo. And he has some publication at that time in 1952 in the British Journal of Dermatology, observations on the use of Amimagus lineus in vitiligo, also in conjunction with Professor Fitzpatrick in the archives of dermatology in 1966, hydroquinone and sorolens in the therapy of hypermelanosis and vitiligo. This regime of therapy is a cornerstone in treating vitiligo up till now. But regarding the laser time, in fact, Egypt was a little bit delayed in introducing this maneuver. With the emergence of the light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation laser in the world, Professor El Tonsi introduced the first device to Egyptian universities in 1989. The laser dermatology unit at Minya University, which is my university, was the first dermatological laser unit in Egypt. Was established 1989 by Professor Mohamed Hani Tonsi, who was the first professor and chairman of the Dermatology and STDs and Andrology Department at Minya University. Minya is south to Cairo, 3 hours by train. Professor Tonsi studied in the States and came back to Egypt and had a dream of establishing the newest dermatologic department at that time as highly specialized scientific department with all sub-specialties, mainly dermatologic surgery, laser, cosmetology, histopathology, and andrology. And the first laser unit installed was an ND-YAG long-pulsed laser. This laser was chosen after a scientific research at that time of the available laser units at, and the needs and the application required by the population in the region. The ND-YAG laser from Carl Zeiss, Germany, was installed mainly with the purpose of treating vascular congenital anomalies, which includes port wine stains, hemangiomas, and lymphangiomas. During the era of the 1980s, the main dermatologic laser used was the ND-YAG laser, but the use of this laser was markedly decreased due to its scarring nature on the skin. Professor Lantaler from Germany was the one who has reintroduced this laser again after publishing paper in treatment of congenital vascular anomalies. In 1991, the first research was started to investigate and establish the parameter required to treat different dermatologic conditions. This study was conducted by Dr. Abdelrahim under the supervision of Dr. Lantaler in Germany, Professor El Tonsi and Daruti in Egypt. Dr. Abdelrahim went to Germany for 2 years to perform a study on the application of the ND-YAG laser in dermatology. Dr. Abdelrahim now is a chairman of dermatology department in Fayoum University, Egypt, another university. As a result of the numerous research, including the application of ND-YAG and FPDL in vascular anomalies, we published during the period from 1993 to 1996 some papers in International Journal, British Journal of Dermatology, 1995, laser therapy of childhood hemangiomas in the therapy of vascular lesions in the head and neck area by means of argon, ND-YAG, CO2, and flash lamp pump pulsed dye lasers in otorhinolaryngology, side effects and complications of flash lamp pump pulsed dye laser therapy or for port wine stains, a prospective study in the British Journal of Dermatology in 1996. Not only in vascular lesion, but evaluation of ND-YAG was also carried out in many skin disorders like Leishmania, like keloids, like some benign and malignant tumors. And then during the era of hyperthermia, a new technique for treatment of verruca vulgaris, which is Regensburg technique, by the use of ND-YAG laser hyperthermia was described in 1993 and followed by other publications in 1994. this publication, NDIAG laser hyperthermia and treatment of recalcitrant verruga vulgaris. Dr. Abdelrahim participated in this publication in ACTA, Dermatology and Venereology, in 1994. It was observed that malignant tumor cells are more sensitive than normal cells to heat. Hyperthermia is known to be cytotoxic at temperature above 94 degrees Celsius and selectively lethal to cancer cells. This is another publication, NDIAG laser hyperthermia and treatment forts, a new modification of a new technique in the Egyptian Journal of Dermatology and Venereology, 1997. Use of NDIAG laser hyperthermia in treatment of precancerous skin lesions, MINIA technique, was described also to treat precancerous skin lesions, including actinic keratosis, Bounds disease, and malignant condition. In Dermatology Online 2004, continuous wave NDIAG laser hyperthermia, successful modality in treatment of basal cell carcinoma. As you can see, some picture of some cases before treatment and after hyperthermia with NDIAG laser at that time. Another patient before and after, and also proved at histopathological level. Some other publication, evaluation of NDIAG laser versus combined cryotherapy and intralesional corticosteroid injection in treatment of keloids and hypertrophic scars in 1997 in Journal of Pan-Arab League. Density of viral particles in pre- and post-NDIAG laser hyperthermia therapy and cryotherapy in plantar warts, 1992, International Journal of Dermatology. Focus in the IPL treatment and rejuvenation, hair removal, vascular lesion was conducted from 1997 to 2001. Use of excimer laser and treatment of psoriasis vitiligo was carried out between 2004 and 2007. The use of alexandrite laser on hair removal, long pulsed alexandrite in removal of pigmented skin lesion was carried out till 2007. This some other publication. Granuloma pyogenicum, complication in flash lamp pumped pulse dialysis in dermatology, evaluation of laser hyperthermia versus CO2 laser, combined long pulsed NDIAG KTP laser with controlled selective cooling in dermatology, 308 nanometer excimer laser for treatment of vitiligo and psoriasis, and low-level IPL therapy for management of recalcitrant post-herpetic neuralgia. These are some recent publications. In the most recent department research in 2007, carbon dioxide laser and erbium YAG laser in atrophic facial scars, a comparative study, and efficiency of carbon dioxide laser resurfacing, fractional erbium YAG laser resurfacing, 95 trichlorosilicic acid, chemical peeling, cryopeeling, treatment of acne scars. These some cases before and after CO2 scar correction, and facial post-acne pits treatment. Also, the study correlated this improvement with new collagen regeneration in the dermis. Many research works were conducted in collaboration with many local and international laboratories, and many publications were issued. And laser centers now are now available in different provinces of Egypt, and lasers became a main tool in the armamentarium of dermatologists required to manage many skin conditions. And the next IPTA meeting will be a nice finish, or not finish, but continuation of the laser in Egypt. So as Professor Oshir said, Irashai for us when we came here, we say Ahlan in Egyptian language or Arabic language, which means you will find family when you visit us 2011 in Egypt. And thank you.